This is the first presentation under the heading Design of Steel Structures. Steel is the most powerful construction material as it can carry tension, axial tension, axial compression, flexure and almost all the forces if it is analyzed, designed and detailed properly. Let's go through the course content of the subject. The first chapter includes the introduction to steel as a structural material, in which the general introduction will be discussed and introduction to the design methodology of steel structure will be discussed. The second chapter is about designing of the axial members, that are the members subjected to the axial forces, like design of tension members and design of compression members. The next chapter is about the design of flexural members. The next chapter, design of connections, which includes bolted connection design as well as welded connection design. And the last one is introduction to spatial structures. This could be the assignments which one can adopt to complete the syllabus and to review it properly. This could be the references for the subject. So let's start with the first chapter, that is introduction to steel as a structural material. In that, the first part is about the general introduction. So in this presentation, we are going to discuss part 1 out of the 3 parts of the general introduction. Let's discuss the industrial requirements first. As we all know that the steel is the most powerful material used for the industrial structures. So what are the key requirements of the industrial structures and why steel fits the most suitable material for the industrial structure? So the key requirement of the industrial structures are, or the key factors in industry are, functional requirements, cost effective construction, then we have to construct the structure within the given time, that is confined time frame, less efforts to construct the building, and sustainability. So these are the key factors in the industry. Let's discuss one by one all the key factors. So first is functional requirements of the industry. So what could be the functional requirements of the industry? So in industry, we require large open space to work. So it could be not a single structure, but also as per the requirement of the particular industry, it could be many units. It could carry many units like administrative units and other units such as canopies, washrooms, then some might need kitchen, etc. The next is heavy equipment. So we need cranes, ducts, heavy equipments which also require a large open space, and we need to control the vibrations. So these are the functional requirements of the industry. Cost effectiveness. How we could achieve the cost effective, how we could achieve this target? So we could achieve this target by providing effective structural system, optimum use of the material. Also we can use the composite material to make the structure cost effective. The next is confined time frame. So how we could achieve this key factor of our industry? So, the time is the most important factor in the industry. Delay in a single day to start may lose around crore of rupees in the industry. So, structure must be completed within the confined time frame. How we could achieve it? So, we can use the proper erective and proper construction procedures. Less efforts to construct. So use available rolled sections. In the next lectures, you would be able to understand what is the difference between the rolled sections and sections which are made up by three different elements. That is called as a built-up section. Also, we can achieve it through the proper connection design, availability of erecting instruments, proper methods of erection. And the last one is sustainability. Maximum attempt to reach all the above includes functional, cost-effective, confined time frame, less effort to construct, etc. Also, we have to achieve the life hazardous bylaws like fire, etc. Out of these five, cost-effectiveness, then confined time frame, less effort to construct, and sustainability are the role and responsibility of a structural engineer. Now, we have understood the key requirements of the industry. Okay, so now we will discuss why steel is the most suitable material for the industry. We have understood the key requirements. Now we'll see the steel. Why steel only for industrial structures? So the first one is speed of construction. Lightweight units we can achieve through the steel design, adaptability for the future extension, and we can prefabricate the sections in the workshop. Also, we could achieve the long spans through the steel over lower sectional depth are achieved. Here in the image, you can see the clear difference between the RCC construction and the steel construction. Here between these two columns, there is a large open space. So we don't need any column here. And also you can see the slender section as a beam section. While in RCC, the distance between the two columns are very less, and yet the depth of the beam that is required is very much high. So through these images, we can easily compare the steel section and the RCC section with the help of these images. That is, we could achieve the longer span with slender sections with the help of steel as a material. The next is the permanent slab formwork. So we don't need to use the regular formwork to construct the slab. We need to use the corrugated sheets, which gives the high strength. Also, it provides the permanent slab formwork. We have to achieve this bonding between the section and this corrugated sheet through these shear keys. If you can see here, these are shear connectors. So this is how we could attach the corrugated sheet and the steel beam. Above that, the reinforcement cage is prepared, and then we can pour the concrete for the slab. Now we don't need to remove this corrugated sheet. So it is effortless construction, and also it reduces the time. So we can construct the steel structure within time frame as per the requirement of the industry. The next is optimum site options for site joint. That means we can also fabricate the members in the fabricate and erect the members in the factories, or we can also connect the fabricated members at the site. So both the options are available for the steel structure. Now let's discuss all these key factors in detail. That is speed of construction, lightweight units, adaptability of future expansion, then prefabrication in workshop, long span, lower sectional depth, permanent slab formwork, and option for side joints. How and why we could achieve these requirements of industrial structure through steel as a material? So, steel has a high strength. The high strength of a steel per unit weight means that the structure made up of steel section weight loss and it could be very lightweight structures. Then RCC. High ductility. Everyone knows that the ductility is the key factor if we want to construct the earthquake resistant building. So, through this high ductility quality of the steel, the seismic loading can be resisted by the steel structures if, again, analyzed, designed and detailed properly. The uniformity, the quality of the steel is intensive construction under the supervision. Most of the steel sections are fabricated in the factories under the constant supervision. Also, the properties of the steel do not change appreciably with the time. So, uniformity in the steel structure is maintained. The next is, it is environmental friendly. Structural steel is recyclable and it can be readily disassembled at the other end of its useful life and can be reused also. So, it is recyclable and reused. During the construction also, no air pollution, noise pollution, land pollution will be there and very less consumption of water. Our industry is almost blamed to use more water because we need more water to cure the concrete. But if we use the steel as a structural material, that could be environmental friendly construction. Versatility. So we could construct, we could fabricate and erect any shape and size of a steel member. Prefabrication, we have already discussed that steel sections can be manufactured in the factory under the supervision. So that could save the manufacturing time and also the errors would be very less in the steel structures. Now, it could have a long life. Like the examples Eiffel Tower and railway bridge across the 5th and 4th, both built in 1890s and still they are fit. But here we have to remember that the maintenance must be there. Otherwise, this will not be there in the advantage of the steel structure. Next is addition to existing structure. It is very easy to join two steel members through a welded or bolted connection. So definitely it could be achieved that if we have a single unit and if we want to make progress and if we want the other structure next to the first structure, we can easily achieve through the bolted or welded connections. Next is least disturbance to the community. All the above things, that is, it is environmental friendly due to the speed of construction and due to the supervision, we could achieve this least disturbance to the community. Okay. Next is fracture toughness and the last one is elasticity. Due to its toughness and ductility, steel members can be subjected to large deformations during the fabrication and erection without fracture, thus allowing them to bend, hammered, sheared and have holes punched into them without visible damage. And elasticity, steel behaves over closer to design assumption because it follows Hooke's law up to the fairly high stresses. Unlike RCC. Now, although we have discussed the advantages and why steel is the most suitable material for the industry, it also contains some disadvantages. So, what are the disadvantages? The maintenance cost. Most steel are susceptible to corrosion when freely exposed to air and water and must therefore be periodically painted. Fireproofing cost. We all know that if the temperature is increased, the length of the steel member will be increased. If the temperature is decreased sustainably, then we could be having the decrement and this increment and decrement would affect the design. So fireproofing system will protect the steel from sudden rise of a temperature due to fire. So for the industrial structure, whenever the steel is used as a structural material, main structural material, then prior fireproofing must be there. Also, the steel is susceptible to buckling. What is buckling and what is the difference between bending and buckling? So here there is a compression member, that means two forces are compressing the member, and these two forces are applied axially on the member. So due to this axial compression, the member would bend like this. So this bending under the axial compression force is called as a buckling. So steel members or the slender compression steel members are susceptible to buckling like this. The fatigue. The joints, if are not designed properly for the fatigue load, fatigue that is applied and removed load, applied and removed load. So if the section is not properly designed for the fatigue load, then the connection would be failed in the fatigue. Okay, so thank you so much. And in the next lecture, we will be discussing the second part of the general introduction. Thank you.